Hi guys, and welcome back to SITENG. In today's video, we're going to talk about the piling works, and I'm going to show you the two GA drawings showing the arrangement for the piles by the two different designers, and we're going to have a look at the piling schedules as well, and I'm going to tell you what you're going to find there and where to look for the information. So yeah, let's go. So guys, I'm gonna go to our folder A and C, drawings, and we're gonna have a look at the piling here. And the first drawing gonna be GA, it's a general arrangement, the plan drawing when you're gonna see all the piles, and this is for block C. So as always, we just go have a look here if this is the latest revision, and first of all, if this is for construction. So you can see now, yeah, this is C1 issued for construction. This is good news. Once downloaded from our platform, drawing platform, that means that's the latest one. And then it says, yeah, piling layout sheet 2 out of 4. So we know now there's a 3 more drawings showing the piles, just to complete this block C. All information here, that's okay. We know the latest revision, we have some notes here, do not scale from these drawings. And we're gonna have a look, continued on, that's our designer drawing. And we have here also continued on drawing number 64, and this side is continued on the drawing number 61. So as you can see, there's not a very complicated drawing. You see the piles here, and you see the number of the piles. The thing is, in the setting out of piles, we most cases we're going to be using the robotic EDM, so we're going to be actually using the drawing showing us the piles and the pile number. So that's very easy, but this is just showing the piles anyway, so you can always refer to drawing. And that's what I always recommend, you're going to keep the paper copy with you all the time. So we got the legend here, denotes side boundary, and 4 piles at grid line, MJC piling details produced by, that's the other designer. Piling notes refer to drawing 61. So we're gonna have a quick look at drawing 61 as well. And then you can see the continuation drawing number 64. I got drawing number 64 here. So that looks exactly the same. It just shows you the corner of the building with the piles. We got some notes here. Pile diameters indicated on this drawing. And noted, why this is open. I just wanna close this. I just wanna show you this closer. Pile diameters indicated on the drawing and noted on the pile schedule are 600 maximum. Now color, that's the piling contractor, have completed their final design. So they're gonna be 450s and 400 piles. But if you're gonna be working for a piling contractor, you're gonna probably have all drawing with the old piles all together, and you're gonna mark them up for yourself, which gonna make your life easy, taking from the piling schedule, taking the diameter of the piles, and then marking them with different colors. That's gonna give you the different areas for the piling. Sorry guys, I got the drawing 61 now, and I downloaded it quickly. Actually, I didn't know there gonna be notes here, but that's actually first drawing, so we should actually start from sheet number 104. And in this case, actually, on this sheet, we got the most information. So we got all notes here. You can see all dimensions in the all levels in meters or dimension in millimeters, unless noted otherwise. This drawing is to be read in conjunction with all relevant engineers, architects, and specialist drawings as always. Setting out dimensions to be checked by contractor. Concrete notes. So that's what we might be interested in. All concrete to be in accordance with BS. So that's the and PP piling specification document. So there will be some specification about the concrete, but this is once the concrete gonna be by an order that has to be done on this level. So we as engineers, as especially as doing setting out, we're not gonna be much involved in this one. All below ground works to be in accordance with BS. So that's the code of practice, yes. Concrete grade to be mix RC40 unless noted UNO, that means unless noted otherwise. So you can see this is RC40, so we know now this minimum concrete for 40 newtons and DC4. But I'm going to tell you more about these things in the structures series. So all reinforcement bars shall be in accordance with BSN. So that's, yeah, 500 newtons per millimeter square. All wire mesh, so that's all nodes. Okay, yield bars. All concrete soffits and sides that are cast against ground shall be protected by 50 millimeter blinding polyethylene sheeting or shattering while in the wet state. I don't get it. It's not for piling. I think that's going to be for pile caps. Oh yeah, that was general notes, maybe that's why, but that's the piling notes now. So specification for piling works is the ICE specification for piling. Okay, piles are to be designed in accordance. So yeah, we're gonna go, usually you just want to read it at least once, just to make sure you're not missing anything, but that's the general notes. Projection of pile cap, this is quite important for us. This we're going to use later when we're going to be doing pile caps. We want to know the projection, so we might be looking for it in the pile cap drawing, but this is actually here. Projection of pile cap reinforcement to be advised by the piling contractors. That's one, but this must be however never less than 600 above cutoff level for piles in compression only, and to extend to end lap with the pile cap ground beam, crane base, wherever it is. Reinforcement for any piles with tension load. So yeah, we know now that 600 is a minimum anchorage level for our steel once we gonna break the piles to the cutoff level, and the contractor shall be responsible for issuing the piling. Yeah, so all this contractors responsible for the piling mat design and all temporary works associated with the installation of the piles. So that would be us. The design settlement of the piles to be maximum of 10 millimeters at working load and 1.5 times the working, yeah. So it's not very, very interesting for us. The important note for us was the one with the pile anchorage. Bailing pile, so this is about the design here. So you can see there was a phase two ground level investigation report. And based on that report, obviously the designer just designed the piles, the length of the pile and the type of the pile release. So we got a pile type here based on CFA, subject by specialist. Pile diameter is based on 600 unless noted otherwise, but subject to pile specialist requirements. Pile spacing, 3 diameters of the piles, so that's spacing in between the piles. You cannot have a 2 piles closer than 3 diameters in between. Final design of piles and above assumptions will be subject to reappraisal by the piling contractor. And now we're going to have a look at the piling schedule. As always, we're going to be checking this drawing with the piling schedule. They always come together. So in the piling schedule, you're going to see there are going to be 400, 450 piles, and you're going to have a coordinates for the piles as well. So yeah, that's the GA. You got the notes here. You got some notes here as well for pile schedule refer. Yeah, so on this drawing, we got everything really. We know we have to refer to drawing number 77 for the piling schedule. Third, piling contractor design. The as-built pile position are to be surveyed on a daily basis and issued to the client for review. So this is a very important thing for us. We know now this is even imposed by the designer that the as-built has to be done every day. So once the pile is done, and that was the engineer was doing this, the pile was finished, he was doing the as-built survey as well. And this is very good for him. Once you're using your robotic instrument, once you mark the point using the stakeout, you can later, using the same job, you're going to be staking the point doing the as-built, and that's going to show you what piles are done as well. That's going to be like another level of checking. The worst thing can happen, you can actually miss one of the piles, and trust me, this is possible. I work on one side when the project manager for the piling contractor, he actually believed he missed one pile. Fortunately, it wasn't the case. He found it later in some pile logs, but he was stressed, believe me. So we got some notes here as well. Pile loads indicated are for the permanent case loads only. Contractor to ensure the concrete mix. Specification for every intended pour for the block C is forwarded to retro client engineers and approved in writing. Concrete class to be AC4S/DS5. So that's another thing. But obviously these things, guys, I'm going to probably tell you more about in the structures while I'm going to be telling you about the materials. This, of course, all this stuff have to be approved by the client, and before you use any materials, they have to be approved. So that will be all. I just jump now to the piling schedule. That's drawing 77, which we seen on that one. You can have a look. You got the pile numbers here. That's how the piling schedule looks. So what we're going to be looking first, of course, if this is for construction, So this is actually for construction. I believe it's the same date as the GA, so that means that's okay. They always go together, but we as engineers, as a setting out engineers in this case, we're going to be going by this drawing. So this is very important that we use in this one as the latest one. But that's the thing I showed you. We check in the revision, and once we have it from the drawing platform, that's probably going to be the latest one. So I just show you some notes here as well. So that's the general notes in meters, millimeters, so we don't have to go again by this. Obviously, you want to read all of it once you have a drawing on site. Denotes characteristic value of permanent action, denotes characteristic value of loading variable. Yeah, so that's all. We're not really interesting very much in this now, as this is loads and action, and probably some, loads and action. Piles denoted those to be designed with reduced capacity due to spacing being less than 3 diameters. So there will see, actually, there will be some piles which don't go by that first legend note we had looked before, but they're going to be marked different way, and the contractor shall be responsible for issuing the piling design and details. Pile loads indicated are for permanent case load only. Any additional loads for temporary works must be provided by temporary works engineer where applicable. So guys, in this case, we didn't have any of the temporary works. So we got pile number 1, P2, P3, we got the cutoff level here. We're going to be using this as well later when we're going to be constructing the piling caps, the pile caps. We got pile diameter, but you can see here it says max diameter 600. So they're going to only be showing here 600, but this is the piling contractor, and once you're going to be working for once, then you're going to know what pile, what diameter will be. And as I said, you're going to have your own drawing with the own markup, what piles going where, and that's how you're going to be working. But what we want to know, we got coordinates here, and this is the most important thing for us here. So we got position of the piles, and that's what we really need as engineers. So guys, I'm just going to quickly show you, because this is the other designer doing the block C and the other doing block A. So I'm going to show you guys quickly the block A drawing, and this is general arrangement. So you can see here now, that's all block A. So this is one drawing for all the block. Very good. I don't see the reason actually why making one drawing in 4 pieces. This is only piling. So piling position, and then you got a piling schedule. So if there is more information, you want to split these drawings into more. But anyway, so we got the same story, which had the latest revision. So there was a C4 piles moved to suit existing ones. Yeah, we had this situation here. Once we were digging down, we had existing piles in the ground, and I was doing actually the survey of these. So you can see they were here. Existing piles surveyed on 28 with 860 millimeters influence zone shown. So we actually surveyed these piles. We broke them down later to the bottom of the piling mat. So the designer have to change the position of the new piles to suit. As you can see here, there was probably 4 piles. I believe it was here, 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 and here. And it's now a little bit at the angle, but it's going to make its job taking the load to the ground. So yeah, that's it. Drawing looks quite all right. We got different colors, and we're going to see now the notes as well. So yeah, this is typical notes. Do not scale from the drawing. For further general notes, RC estimates, grid setting out, for site setting out, capping beam layout. Yeah, but we're gonna go through the capping beam for liner wall. This all gonna be done later, and we're gonna have a look at the drawings for these elements later as well. So we got a piling notes here. Piles are to be designed, but it's probably really similar story to the ones we had a look before with the other designer. The contractor should allow to probe each pile position to ensure there are no obstructions that may delay the piling. So we found actually obstruction. We were doing the probing of the piles at the higher level, but this at the lower level, we actually found this one, existing one. So you can see the survey was done, and the piles, new design piles, were changed. Access for piling will be created, the main contractor. So this is all typical notes. Pile reinforcement shall project a minimum of 600 or 40 times bar diameter. So that's what I was using. Sometimes we had a really long bar, so I just kept 40 times the diameter above. You can see on my video covering the pile caps. The engineer shall be advised immediately of any pile displacement. So that's, you can see, this is also the matter of doing the as-built. So this is very important. The as-built has to be done, and then they have to be provided to the client. All pipes are to be integrity tested to ensure they are free of any significant defect. So as you can see also on my construction site series videos, you can see actually the integrity test pile, and I'm going to show you this here as well. A minimum of 2 concrete test cubes are to be, so this is all taking the cubes, checking the concrete strength, if this is compliant with the design. Piles to comply with recommendation to the site investigation report, so that's the ground report done before. Concrete below ground to conform to recommendations. Pile design for tension depth. Okay, so we're gonna have a look now. We have the legend here about the colors. So we have a coloring denotes varying pile cutoff levels. So in this case, that's gonna be different cutoff levels for different colors. Gray unlabeled piles denote contiguous wall scheme, that's okay. Denotes pile to have lightning protection, refer to cutting drawings. So this actually, I'm gonna show you, that's gonna be actually in the next video when I'm gonna start covering the capping beam drawings, as we're gonna be connecting our lightning protection into the piles. So this symbols gives us location here, but we're gonna double check this later with actually RC cutting drawing, which is actually the designer for the lightning protection for the whole building. So as you could see, we got all grid lines, all the information. We're gonna have a quick look at the pile schedule for this one. We got the different colors here. This denotes cutoff level. And once you're gonna be doing the setting out, you're probably gonna have your own drawings with the different colors, but in this case, I believe your colors, or wherever you're gonna mark it really, but they're gonna be denoting the pile diameter. So I'm gonna show you quickly the piling schedule for this block here, which is here. And oh, you can see it. So it's the same colors here, you know, now it's very good to work with this drawing. So actually later when we're going to be doing the pile caps, we're going to use these drawings just to double check if the pile cutoff level is okay. Once we have a pile cap depth and we know the projection of the piles are 75 mil, we can compare with this and make sure there is no mistake. And you can see we got the easting, northing here, and the pile number. So what we're going to do again, we're going to do the same as on my first video when we were transferring the coordinates for the main control. We just copy these points and we're going to paste them in the notepad and then later transfer them into the EDM. So yeah, if you can have a look at that first video, so that's going to be exactly the same story. We can have a quick look here at the notes. So pile to be designed, contractor should allow to probe. So that's the same notes as from that GA drawing. Schedule coloring denotes varying pile cutoff levels. Yeah, so we know that from the GA as well. So guys, I think that will be all in terms of drawings. If you got any questions, please let me know in the comments. And always keep these two drawings together and make sure this is the latest revision. You want to have a piling schedule and a piling GA together all the time with you once you're doing these jobs. So hey guys, thank you again for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn the notifications on, and as there are going to be more and more videos coming now. The next one going to be the capping beam drawing, where we're going to see all these lightning protection things, all this pile testing, so that's going to be very interesting. And I think this video is now going to be more and more interesting once we get to the construction elements. So yeah guys, thank you again and see you next time.